Britons urged Harry stop airing royal gossip, but Americans hungry for devastating truth bombs. Most British people want Prince Harry to stop talking about the private lives of the royal family, an exclusive Sunday Express poll reveals today. But the majority of Americans are still hungry for more of his devastating truth bombs. Our poll reveals 61% believe he should now stop revealing secrets, while 39% say he should not be silenced. But a separate poll in America asking the same question reveals 59% feel he should continue, with only 41% wanting him to keep quiet. Harry has said that all the profits from the book, and the signing fee is likely to be well in excess of $10 million, are to go to charity, and that he was motivated by a desire to show that no matter where we come from, we have more in common than we think. That doesn't mean, however, there is no indirect financial upside to the book, which is already apparently nearly finished. Speculation about the forthcoming memoir will ensure Harry remains an attention-worthy asset until its publication next fall. The big question, of course, is what the memoir will say. Our findings come as it was recently reported that the Duke and Duchess of Sussex will be writing 4 new books in a £29 million deal with US publisher Penguin Random House. Prince Harry has denied claims of a 4-book deal, insisting there is only a memoir which will be published next year. While it is certain to cause further embarrassment in the Queen's Platinum Jubilee year, Harry gets a huge reprieve on both sides of the pond in our poll. An overwhelming 72% of those polled in the UK and 79% in America say he should be invited to attend his grandmother's Jubilee celebrations. And a majority in both countries, 55% in Britain and 73% in the US, believe he should not be stripped of his title as Duke of Sussex. However, many older people in Britain believe the opposite, with 76% of over 65 saying he should be stripped of his title. The research by real-time opinion platform OnePulse received 1,000 responses from the US and 1,003 from the UK. Royal author Margaret Holder said, "People in the UK have a stronger allegiance to the Queen and most want Harry to stop attacking his family." After the devastating Oprah interview and his revelations on the Me You Can't See, there are signs that the public is tired of his complaining about his undoubtedly privileged life. However, in both the UK and the US there is residual sympathy for Harry, possibly related to memories of him walking behind his mother's coffin. The Queen regards Harry and Meghan as much-loved family members, so the public may be guided by her legendary patience in accepting the couple back temporarily. She added, "Although it is technically meaningless in the USA, many there want Harry to keep his title." Views are markedly different here, with a notably large percentage of over 65s wanting him to pay the price for his continuing betrayals. This is a particularly difficult topic for the Queen. She would not want accusations of spite and bullying from the Sussex's fans. She may also feel that Harry should keep the identity she granted him on his marriage. The poll shows that younger people have a greater tolerance of Harry's behavior, but, generally, people in their mid-30s onwards seem to expect more loyalty to the Queen and the royal family. As Harry is now 36, perhaps he should take note. Meghan, meanwhile, is facing family problems of her own. Her estranged father Thomas Markle, 77, is threatening to take her and Harry to court over visitation rights to the grandchildren he has never seen, Archie, 2, and Lilibet, who is 7 weeks old. In a TV interview direct from his home in Mexico, he said he did not want to see the youngsters punished for their parents' bad behavior. He said, "Archie and Lily are small children. They're not pawns. They're not part of the game." However, California family law expert Mark Gross, whose clients have included Charlie Sheen and Lisa Marie Presley, claimed Mr. Markle's case is weak. At the same time, Meghan's estranged half-brother Thomas Markle Jr., 55, is in quarantine in Sydney before joining the cast of a celebrity edition of the Australian reality TV series Big Brother VIP. The two have reportedly not spoken since 2011, and before his sister's marriage in 2018, Mr. Markle Jr. called on Harry to cancel the wedding, telling him in a letter that marrying Meghan would be the biggest mistake in royal wedding history.